My name is Ndoru Dendo. I'm from the University of Venda. I'm studying Bachelor of Earth Sciences in Mining and Environmental Geology. So I'm submitting this video for the purpose of becoming a co-lecturer. So basically, I'm from Limpopo. To be specific, I stay in Loeterkat, or also known as Makado. So here at Makado, we are confined within the Zoutpansberg Mountains. So the Zoutpansberg Mountains more like form the semi-cover, except only on the south side of the town, where it leads to other places. So here in Loeterkat, we receive low winds because of the mountains that we are confined within them. And also one of the other reasons, because we still have trees and we still have a lot of conservationists who still do not believe in cutting trees. And another thing is we receive high rainfall. Wow, this is super cool at some point in time, because you find where some people are complaining about rain, whereas we have it. And this is because we are I'm located directly on the foot of the mountain. So with high rainfall, here's what I figured out today, which is super cool. I was traveling from here to Toyando, which is about 58 kilometers. So after 7 kilometers away from the town, there's the Rutananda River. After the Rutananda River, the climate there is different from the climate on the other side of the Rutananda River, which is here in Loeterkat. So today it was raining here in Loeterkat. It was mildly raining here in Loeterkat. So I was traveling. Né? So here's how I've went, because I was prepared for the rain. So after passing the Rutananda River, I noticed that, in fact, towards it, not after passing, towards it, the rain was slowly deteriorating, to an extent that when we get to the Rutananda River, there was a gradual change of the climate. At the other end, you can notice the rain is still going there, but on the other end, it's gradually becoming low, and the raindrops are becoming thinner. So when I saw that, I was like, wow, this is something that I've never noticed. I even wish I should get out of the taxi and take a selfie because of that. So what I'm trying to tell you about this is that we have a varied or differential climate from here to that side. Because after traveling 20 kilometers, that is in Chakuma, I noticed that there it's hot. There was sun, literally that was sun. And I was like, wow, what's going on? And people, they were wearing vests, and yeah, I was wearing prepared for rain or for coldness. I had to even change though. So the climate differs gradually. So that makes my place where I come from very special. And another thing with the other end of Loeterkat, which is going towards the Njelele area, we have hot springs. So here's what I want to associate those springs with. When we move towards the Bed Bridge, which is in Musina, it's about 100 kilometers from where I come from. So in the Bed Bridge, we have the kimberlite pipes, where the Vanessa mine, they are mining diamonds there. So kimberlite pipes are formed from the volcano. So when that volcano erupted, on the far end, which is the Musina, on the far end of Limpopo, which is the Musina area, the volcano literally erupted. But on the when we coming towards Loeterkat, the volcano didn't erupt. So there was no magma on the surface, so it stayed under the surface. That's when we see hot springs there, and the water is ever warming. So when we come towards the side of Loeterkat, directly into the center of Loeterkat, we find where we have a lot of coal formations, more especially the metamorphosed anthracite. So to my belief, I think that those anthracite were metamorphosed by the volcano that erupted that site. And another thing is, here in Loeterkat, we receive low sunlight. As I've said, we are confined within the Zoutpansberg Mountains, so we have shorter days. During the sunset area, which is on the west side, the mountains have made a peak, so we have shorter days, which is not cool though. But when it comes to sunrise, we receive early sunrises if it's that time of the year. So this, what I just said, makes Limpopo or Loeterkat very super cool. So coming to the broader Limpopo, we have heritage sites. We have the Mapungubwe area, which have caves, which have remains of people who have been known to live decades ago. Paleontologists have dated that to be decades ago. And also we have the Kruger National Park here in Limpopo. And mostly in the Kruger National Park, we have trees that have been dated also to be decades ago. So this makes Limpopo, this makes Loeterkat super cool. Thank you so much.